Chapter 17 of Little Joe Otter by Thornton W. Burgess. Yowler the Bobcat follows. The opportunist oft succeeds because of trifles that he heeds. Little Joe Otter. Yowler the Bobcat, prowling about through the Green Forest, came across the trail of the Otter family. He didn't have to use his nose to follow that trail. Anyone with eyes could follow it. The instant he saw it, Yowler knew who had made that trail.
"Huh," muttered Yowler. "Little Joe Otter has started on his travels again. I wonder where he is going this time."
Then Yowler, more from habit than anything else, put his nose down in that trail and sniffed. A surprising change came over him. He suddenly took great interest in that trail. He had smelled young otters. Little Joe or Mrs. Otter he wouldn't think of attacking. They were too big and strong, and he knew too well how they could fight. But a young otter would be a different matter, even though he might be almost fully grown. Certainly this was a matter worth looking into. So, in his usual sneaking fashion, Yowler followed that trail. And at length he came to the big upturned tree and the hole in the snow that led down under the roots. Very gently, Yowler sniffed. At once his nose was filled with the otter scent. He grinned hungrily. Those otters were down there asleep. It was a great temptation to dig down and try to surprise them. But Yowler knew better than to try this. He looked around. A short distance away was a big hemlock tree. Yowler circled around to it and climbed part way up. Then he crouched on a big limb and prepared to wait for those otters to come out. He didn't have long to wait. He saw the head of Little Joe Otter pop out of that hole in the snow. Then Little Joe came out. He was followed by Mrs. Otter, and then by the two young otters. Yowler's yellow eyes glowed hungrily as he noticed that one of these was smaller than the other. Little Joe started off at once, and the others fell in behind him. Just as soon as he dared to, Yowler dropped down from that tree and began to sneak after them. It was surprising how fast those otters traveled. But Yowler can travel fast, and it wasn't long before he had them in sight. Then he moved more cautiously. He sneaked from tree to tree and took advantage of every stump and bush. For a while, the young otters kept close to their parents. Then, from time to time, they dropped back, as they stopped to examine things that were new to them. Their curiosity satisfied, they would bound ahead to catch up.
"If that smallest otter will just drop far enough behind so that I can get her alone, I think I'll have an otter dinner," muttered Yowler. "Those youngsters have got to see everything that is to be seen. They are like all other youngsters, full of curiosity and heedless. They probably think they are quite able to take care of themselves. It certainly will be worthwhile to follow them for a while. I haven't anything better to do. Besides, I will go a long way for an otter dinner." He licked his lips, and his mouth watered.
End of Chapter 17.